This was our RC2014 Micro Plus at the end of the last video. Today we are going to assemble a backplane, and to do that I soldered the edge connector to the bottom of the board. The backplanes come in a variety of sizes, from 5 slot to 8 slot and even 12 slot to accommodate add-on boards. Today we are going to assemble the 5 slot board, which comprises of 5 edge connectors, 2 resistors, 5 capacitors, an LED, a reset switch, and a barrel jack socket. As always, we will fit the lowest profile components first, namely the resistors and capacitors. The resistors have the usual colour coding, but if in doubt, you can always use a multimeter to tell them apart. The edge connectors have the largest amount of soldering, so take your time, and always check your solder joints visually to ensure you haven't missed any or inadvertently soldered two things together that shouldn't be. Lastly, I fitted the barrel jack socket and the reset button, and the backplane is now ready to be connected to the RC2014 micro board. Now we have our RC2014 micro inserted into our backplane. This allows us to add additional boards. What I'm going to do to make this a little more manageable is to add a frame to this so we can start to make a case. We can do this quite easily using maker beam. With maker beam bolts, we can slide them onto the struts in the grooves provided, and we can screw on little standoffs. And these can slot in to the holes on our backplane board. Once these are screwed into place, we'll just align them with the holes on the board and we can bolt them down. One set in place, and we'll just do exactly the same with the other one. Yep, just needs to move up very slightly. That should be us. Let's tighten these up on the struts, and we're ready to go. And we'll put a little washer on top of each of these so we don't damage the board. And we can fasten on the nuts. And having put these 4 in place, we can now tighten them up. And that is our board held in place, and we can build a case around this frame. The board is still powered by the FTDI power connector, which also does the communications to your main computer. But with the backplane, you do have the option of using a barrel jack, although you do have to actually fit a regulator in order to do this. However, the one advantage of the backplane, apart from the additional slots you get, is there is a power light in the corner of the board, which is very bright and will indicate quite easily when the board is powered on. So if we connect our cable, and we'll now connect this to the computer. And as you will see, the LED light lights up quite happily. I've put our board in the second slot as I have plans for the first slot, but we'll cover that in the next video. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.